I mean, it's just hard to overstate how unprecedented it is to have members of the firm speak out like this so publicly.
Yes, it happens about once every generation or so that a member speaks out. But to have somebody as close as Harry speaking in the way he did, what Meghan says was by far the most serious. But the greater insight came from Harry in the sense when he said that the family is trapped. My father and my brother are trapped. In return, in relation to the media, the tabloid newspaper said they are scared of the tabloids turning on them. And Harry admits his family cut him off. And when he talk about Prince Charles, his father, the future king, he says, Harry says he feels let down by Charles because he felt, bearing in mind what his mother Diana went through, Charles would have recognised the pain, but he did nothing to help Meghan or help the situation. Michael, there's no getting away from it. This is devastating for the royal family, who have spent so long trying to cultivate different images, modern images, a family that's changed, a family that is more in touch with people. And then you get this, which literally blows the whole thing right out of the water. They won't, you know, the other thing to remember, though, is they won't resign. There's no resigning going on here. It's not like a politician. So the family will have to take what they've heard and live with it and manage it. And that's what we'll have to watch and see. But it's very, very damaging.
And to that point, I mean, what is going to be the likely or possible reaction from the palace? I mean, how much pressure will they be under to respond to what are major allegations that are pretty hard to ignore, or does never complain, never explain, continue on?
It would continue on except for one important point. This is Diana Redux. This is Diana who Meghan admits she wasn't helped when she came into the family. She wasn't told anything about protocol or how to handle anything. That's what happened with Diana. Meghan admits that self-harming was very much on her mind. That's what happened with Diana. Diana threw herself down the stairs. Diana suffered from bulimia. And so we end up with a situation where you turn around and say, has this family learned nothing? And I think the key to this is what Meghan said right at the beginning. It's dawned on her after she was in the family that this isn't just a family of celebrities. This isn't just a famous family. This is an institution. And I think you saw that very clearly in the last 24 hours between the work that Charles and William have been doing with Commonwealth Day, staid and solid, and the much more modern, the much more touchy-feely, the much more in tune that we saw with Meghan and Harry tonight. And Meghan simply had no idea what to expect. That is a major failing of the royal family.
You know, the other thing I wanted to get your thoughts on, at the heart of this, and also when it came to Diana as well, is that segment of the British press which does hound and intrude on royal lives. How big of a conversation is the behaviour of those elements of the media, because they clearly are in play here as well?
Yes, and what Harry said blew that up as well. Harry pointed out that there is the scratching of each other's backs, that the media knows they need the royals and the royals know they need the media. But this idea that what Harry said was that they're trapped in an environment that they are stuck in. They put the best, they basically do the best they can because this is how it's meant to be, and they're scared of the tabloids. Michael, I think that the palace is going to have to look at the serious allegations. They're not going to be too concerned about the tabloids and about the relationship and feeling trapped and all of that sort of stuff. They're going to say, yeah, that's Harry, that's his view. But the serious allegations that Meghan says she felt suicidal and that she felt left out and that Charles was told about this, this is on the top, of course, of the Crown, which has already had a very unflattering portrayal of the Prince of Wales. This is going to be very damaging. It will take some time to repair the damage. It's devastating.
is stay with us, Richard. I want to bring Anna back in. I was curious. I mean, you're there in the UK. What of the public reaction to the decision of Harry and Meghan to withdraw? Have they been supportive of that or not? I mean, it's going to be interesting to see how this all plays out. It's already all over British television. It's certainly going to be front page.
Well, that decision that was made last year really shocked the public and really divided opinion. When it came to the tabloid press, it was very much seen as a decision driven by Meghan, and it was often referred to as Megxit. A lot has clearly been revealed in this interview, and I think one of the strongest points was that Harry and Meghan did not want to leave their position as working members of the royal family. They just didn't want to be the senior members of the royal family. They wanted to be able to take a step back. They've said before they didn't want to take a step down. They wanted to continue to do their service, to do their duty, but they felt that they just couldn't. Now, the reaction today will be really interesting. This interview hasn't yet broadcast in the UK. It will broadcast this evening, but of course, so much will be in the newspapers this morning. We'll be getting those as soon as the shops open. It's only 5 o'clock in the morning, Michael, so it's a little bit early, but we will be getting that reaction quite soon. And I think there will be a lot of sympathy for Meghan. This is a woman who has said she felt suicidal, that she asked for help, and no one gave it.
Yeah, yeah. Richard Quest, the other thing too that's striking, you know, about this, we have a situation with what's been going on in recent months has been, you know, competing narratives in a way. The palace, you know, we've heard the leaks that, you know, Meghan was bullying staff and so on. This sort of using of the media to get points across in this way. I mean, a lot of people have said the royal family's fairly dysfunctional, but this is such a fissure in the family.
Nothing new, Michael, about the royal family leaking and using the media. Go back to the, well, you'll have seen it in The Crown when the Queen leaked about her dislike of Margaret Thatcher. It's true. It did happen like that. Go back and look at Diana in her interview with Martin Bashir, which was then followed by Charles's interview with Jonathan Dimbleby, in which he laid into Diana. So this is nothing new. That they've all used the media to get their message across. What I think has happened here that is slightly different, and by the way, Oprah Winfrey did a superb job. I mean, she asked the tough questions in a very polite and respectful way, but nobody got away with anything. She asked Harry, look, don't you want it both ways? Don't you want to be royal so you can make money off Spotify and Netflix, and at the same time, you want to have the freedom? So she gave them a good opportunity to justify their position, which is what they did. They said that they wanted to stay, but they simply felt they couldn't. That's the difference this time, Michael. That's the difference. They left, they've gone to California, and they're now telling their story.
Utterly extraordinary stuff.